I'm using the ODB17 Intro to Queries database for this tutorial. In this video, we're going to take another look at creating a query in SQL and look at some of the common mistakes and errors people make, some typical error messages they might get, and discuss a few things you can do to try and figure out what went wrong and how to fix the errors. We're going to create a query in SQL view. When the SQL screen opens up, it's blank. There's nothing on it. This can be a little intimidating, but let's try and remember from our last video what we need to create some SQL code. We need select, some field names, then from, and a table name. Easy enough. Let's type that in. Everything looks good. I'm going to go up and run it by clicking the Run Query button. And we get an error message. The error message says the data content could not be loaded. Column not found, last name in statement select, last name, first name, department from table employees. So this is telling us that it did find the table, but it did not find the fields. So if we look at our fields again, last name and first name, department, on our table, we started all our fields with a capital letter. So let's type that in. Now it looks good. Let's give it a try. I'm hitting F5 and it runs. Now let's see what would happen if we left out a comma. If we leave out this first comma and try and run it, again I'm hitting F5 to run. It shows us that it got last name and it found department, but it left out first name. But it still ran. I'm going to add that one back. Actually, what happens if we are missing two commas? If I try and run it now, F5, we get a syntax error. Let's see what happens if we have two commas together. If I try and run this, I'm hitting F5, a syntax error. And if we have an extra comma here at the end, again, I'm hitting F5, and we get another syntax error. This syntax error doesn't really tell us too much, but one thing we might want to check is, are there appropriate number of commas and are they in the right place? I'm going to select all the code, delete it, and paste some new code. Here we've got our select, some field names, from, and our table name. That all looks good. I'm going to try and run this by hitting F5, and I get a syntax error in SQL statement. We check the table name, that's spelled correctly. Last name is spelled correctly. First name, we've got the proper case. Everything looks good, but we can't figure out the problem. Let's try and go over to Design View. Clicking that tells us that when we have an SQL syntax error, it cannot move us over into Design View. One thing we can do is going to cut out this code and paste it here into this text file. And because we don't even have a table in here, we can't go over to Design View. So I'm going to exit out. Don't want to save the changes. I'm going to open up Design View, add our table, add our last name, add our first name, and run it. So we see it's working. Now I'm going to go back over into SQL view. I'm going to copy and paste our code from the text file. And we can see that We only had single quotes around our field names and table name. We needed double quotes. So if we can't figure out what's wrong, we can recreate the query in design view and then compare the two. So we don't need this code anymore. And let's reformat this so we can read it a little easier. The select and the from are always capitalized. Do we need these capitalized? I'm going to try making this lowercase. And this one, I'm going to start lowercase and then go to uppercase and try and run it. Hitting F5 shows that it runs. So it doesn't really matter if our select and from are lowercase, uppercase, or any combination. But if we go over to design view and then back, it converts those back to uppercase. Since uppercase is the standard that LibreOffice Base likes, we're going to stick with that. I'm going to reformat this again. These double quotes, do we need the double quotes? I'm going to take them off our table. I'm going to hide the result set. Hitting F5 shows that we do not need double quotes on our table name. How about on our field names? If I take them off the field names and try and run it, there we get an error. So is it the field names, or is it because we have a space in the field name? The way to test this is add in department without the double quotes. I'm going to hide the result set and hit F5. So we do not need the double quotes unless we have a space in the field name. And I believe the same for the table name. We do not need the double quotes unless there is a space in there. Again, if we swap over to design view and then come back, we see that it added in those double quotes again. Since LibreOffice Base adds in those double quotes, we're going to keep that as a standard and put all our fields in double quotes. The last thing we're going to look at is right here. I typed this in to a LibreOffice Writer document. Going to select and copy. Going to select our entire query. Control V to paste. Looks very good. I'm going to hit F5 and try and run this. And we get an error. Data content could not be loaded. Table not found in statement select. So it couldn't even find the table to look to see if the fields are good. How can this be when I type this into a writer document exactly how it was in a working query? So we check the spelling in the case of the table name. That all looks correct. It looks like we have proper quotes. But if I run this again, let's take a closer look at from the table. Looks like we've got two different quotes here. Two sets of double quotes. If I add a double quote outside and another one on this side, we see our table name turns orange. And if we remember earlier, orange seemed to be the color that was working for us. We can also see that these are definitely two different types of quotes. So I'm going to take out the old ones. And we've got the same for our entire query. Now if I run this, it runs. So if I select this all and copy and come back over here to our writer document, going to paste that in, and definitely we can see that the quotes that we need are not in this top part, but the proper quotes are down below. I'm going to delete the one that is bad and keep the one that is good. I'm talking about this now because in my previous video, and probably future videos, my code is just going to work because I've tested it out and we want to keep the video moving. But if a viewer is typing along at home, and especially someone new to SQL, I want to give them some basic starting points on how to go about debugging on their own the SQL code.